We're less than a week away from the start of the fall 2020 semester, and we are so happy to welcome everyone back, even if it's at a distance. Things may be a bit different this fall, but I assure you, we are catamount strong and look forward to an exciting and safe return to campus. But before we look ahead to all that's new this semester, let's look back at some of the highlights from this past year and what a year it's been.
In August of 2019, WCU welcomed 12,000 students to campus for yet another year of record enrollment. And on September 5th, we dedicated our newest residential facility, Laverne Hamlin Allen Hall, in honor of the first African-American student to attend WCU. As a regionally engaged university, we embraced our role as champion of Western North Carolina. The Center for the Study of Free Enterprise hosted an opioid and addiction crisis town hall in collaboration with the Jackson County Community Foundation. We dedicated the Two Sparrowstown Archaeological Collections Curation Facility, further celebrating the history and culture of the Cherokee Nation. Chancellor Brown embarked on a 20-stop welcome tour around the region, meeting and hearing from our WCU alumni, friends, and community. And after months of rehearsal, planning, and anticipation, the Pride of the Mountains Marching Band represented WCU at the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade in front of millions of viewers from around the world.
Catamount Athletics also had plenty to be proud of when our men's basketball team electrified Catamount Country with an exciting season, and women's volleyball finished third in the Southern Conference regular season, with head coach Karen Glover being named SoCon Coach of the Year. Our success in the classroom couldn't be stopped. This spring, Catamount Athletics posted an average team GPA of 3.38, with almost 70% of our athletes earning a 3.0 or higher, and women's soccer's Emily Zippe earning academic All-American accolades.
The Catamount Club raised nearly $2 million, with $1.53 million of that going directly towards student-athlete scholarship support. We also successfully raised the money to outfit the new turf at Bob Waters Field and also added the last golf simulator in our indoor practice facility to create an enhanced space for our student-athletes. And finally, we welcome back one of our own, and Alex Gary, a student-athlete alumni here, to join WCU as our new athletic director.
We have also seen substantial changes to our physical space here on campus this year. Scott and Walker Hall have been brought offline and will be coming down over the coming year to make way for brand new first-year residence halls. The Office of Undergraduate Admissions has relocated to a new 21st century space in HF Robinson, and a new front entrance sign has been added to welcome our future Catamounts to campus. Construction is also continuing for the new Apodaca Science Building and Ramsey Center facade. And finally, our steam plant got its final funding approved by the state legislature. We have always been about striving for excellence here at WCU, and these projects will allow us to continue offering the best experience possible for our students.
We may have had a challenging year, but the academic achievement never stopped. Project Interact was created from a $1.25 million grant designed to train graduate students in psychology, special education, and speech pathology in order to address the complex needs of children with autism. In honor of Black History Month, Hunter Library presented the City of Hope, a Smithsonian exhibition highlighting Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s final and most ambitious vision that each U.S. citizen have the equal access to economic opportunity and the American dream. The Student Success Innovation Lab was awarded $202,000 for the WCU Finish Line Completion Grant, supporting students who are at financial risk of not completing their college career. And that's only a few of the incredible efforts of our faculty, staff, and students.
And then, out of nowhere, our entire year changed. As COVID-19 began to spread across the country and the globe, our priorities immediately changed to the protection of our WCU family and the community around us. In an instant, our campus became quiet as we sent students, faculty, and non-essential staff home. We have felt the heartbreak as our students, faculty, and staff missed major milestones like graduation, spring sports, and student research. But in that same instant, our sense of resilience was felt immediately. our faculty and students work together to adapt to new ways of learning, engaging, and connecting with one another through distance. Our staff were on the front lines to help redefine and support our new priorities, keep the campus moving forward, and adjust to our new normal, all at a distance. Our WCU family did what family does and jumped in to support in any way possible, like our health and human sciences students performing wellness checks for at-risk senior citizens in our community. Our engineering students putting their 3D printers to work, making PPE for local businesses and healthcare providers. And through all of the uncertainty, our fine and performing arts students continue to use their creativity to bring art to our community through virtual performances and showcases.
This year has been like no other, and we will never forget it. We have experienced unprecedented times and have been challenged, faced uncertainty, and felt a great deal of fear. But we embraced these challenges and persevered, as a campus, as a community, but mostly as a family. The courage and commitment of our faculty, staff, and students have shown through, and we could not have been prouder. We may look back at this year as one of the toughest, and it was, but we will always remember it as the year we saw what being Catamount proud truly meant. We want to thank each and every one of you for the difference you have made in this challenging year. And as always, go Cats!